this topic of older horses must be have a preliminary statement, which is not going to make a lot of you happy. But if you'd started flowing their teeth when they're young, the chances of them having a problem as they're older is greatly diminished. And this is why. The horse, when chewing comfortably without any pain in its mouth, can put the correct amount of pressure on its teeth, which stimulates the tooth to remain healthy in the horse's mouth. It's when the horse has trouble on one side and starts to chew on one side, and the other side is allowed to start to wiggle in the air, if you will, some of these teeth start to get loose, they start to get infections around their socket, and some of these teeth either become infected or, more commonly, they just fall out. And with that comes a little bit more care on management from your part. In other words, mashing some food and feeding chopped hay and doing all these other things that will help a horse swallow. Because once they start to lose a couple of teeth, all the fluoride in the world isn't going to help these guys, because they don't, the food that the food is being located by the tongue in between the teeth, and the teeth aren't there, and so the food still spills out and the horse starts to lose weight. The biggest concern I have with an older horse that's losing weight that's caused by teeth is either an overgrown tooth or a tooth that's been allowed to tilt into the cheek that creates a huge hole in there, or going into the tongue with a sharp edge. It's just making it impossible. But what's really nice about those is a quick float to get them comfortable usually helps them tremendously. Now, here's the big caution. A lot of times a dentist will see all these problems in an older horse and they'll just go to town and correct everything all at once. And what happens is that floating action actually vibrates the teeth, which creates an immense amount of pain. And some of these horses won't eat for a week, sometimes up to a month, that I've heard. So whenever I go in and start floating teeth, I listen for and I feel for loose teeth. They just kind of rattle and shake in their sockets. And those guys, I just do the very bare minimum to make them comfortable, and then warn the owners to have some Banamine on hand, because this horse may stop eating and need some painkiller. But then you come back, you know, 3 months, 6 months later, and those teeth that were wiggling before are now solid in the socket, which is so incredible. And then you can get a little bit more aggressive and take more down. And so over three or four floats, these guys actually become more comfortable having their teeth floated. And they're not old crotchety guys, you know, anymore. They say, oh yeah, Doc, I remember you. You made me feel good. So older horses, basically prevent any tooth problems by starting your horses young and keeping up on it. But if you get an older horse that has not been maintained well, go lightly at first. Don't try and correct everything at once. You may have the horse off feed for weeks, if not months, and try and make the horse comfortable in every way that you can. Management-wise, wet the hay, chop the hay, make a bran mash, do whatever you can to get the food past the gullet, because once it's past there, it'll do just fine. These older horses sometimes just can't get it back past their throat. All right, that's the specialties for older horses.